Hi everybody, Sanbonani. Welcome to Reality Bites TV, where we talk about all things reality TV shows and all things reality TV show stars. So listen, you guys, now we are going to talk about, is it episode 14? The finale of Ingane Zesithembu. This is part two of the review, because I just wanted to talk about this part separately from the part where they are fighting with Ne. Now it's Tirelo and Vuyo and Pumelelo and Vicky. Now, you guys, overall, I didn't like Tirelo in this part of the episode. I didn't like what she was doing with Vuyo. At the same time, I feel like Vuyo is just looking like stupid at this point. Because why are you still fighting for this man? Because you've broken up with him. You've told everybody that you broke up with him. Yes, we understand you're mad, because normally when you break up with somebody, it's not like a day thing where you like say it's over and then the next day you're over him. So I kind of feel like maybe she was hoping that going to Sun City, they were going to be able to fix their relationship with Pumelelo, because I'm not understanding why she is still fighting. She looks stupid at this point. Like, girl, just move on. Istima, sakonko siyam istima. But I feel like these girls don't care about istima, right? Because otherwise, bonke nje no Vicky, bonke guys, I feel like abanandaba nesidima sabo la mantombazane. Anyway, you guys, so let me talk about what happened so that you can understand why I feel the way that I feel. So the fight with Usne has happened. Bilo is irritated. She tells everybody, listen, dinner is over, let's go to sleep. They leave, okay? Tirelo stands up to leave, okay? But I guess she still had things to say, because I don't know, maybe she wanted closure for her weave. She was like, okay, my weave is not fitting, okay, really closure, okay? Because while she's leaving, she's saying some things, and then Tirelo says, I still want answers, okay? And Vicky's like, girl, you are going to get answers from your man, okay? And I do feel like that. But the relationship got is between her and Pumelelo. She should have waited, bakulume late. Anyway, you guys, Uvuyo starts saying, listen, as long as the kids are fine, at some point she mentions the singabako, as long as singabako and the kids are fine, then I'm fine. I'm not against your relationship. You guys can be happy there, but I won't tolerate Mpumelelo's behavior, okay? Now, you guys, now she comes back to sit Uvuyo, which I didn't understand. This is the thing I was talking about, where they are attempting to leave and then they're coming back. She comes back to sit down. Now, you guys, I did get Tirelo's point, because Tirelo is like, okay, now let's clarify things. If Pumelelo had made you umamkulu, would you have stayed? And Uvuyo says, yes, I would have stayed. And then she says, yes, I would have stayed, but, okay, now, here's the thing. You are trying to convince us, Uvuyo, that you left because of Pumelelo's nonsense, okay? He is being disrespectful, he doesn't listen, and yada 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 yada. That's what you want us to believe, okay? But at the same time, you are saying that if he made you umamkulu, you would stay. So basically, you are not leaving because of the nonsense, you are leaving because you are not mamkulu. Had he given you a mamkulu position, you would have stayed and tolerated the nonsense, because you had already tolerated the nonsense for years, okay? I understand Tirelo's point there, but I feel like it wasn't her place to ask those questions, because I don't feel like Uvuyo owes her a lot. They could have done a closure thing between the two of them over the phone, which I get kelang say no mam kurako, but you know, no hard feelings, okay? So I felt like Tirelo at that point, she wasn't able to hide the fact that she is very happy that Uvuyo is leaving the relationship, that now she's going to be the only one, because as we have found out that Unosiponaye has walked away from the relationship. I actually thought that the whole relationship with Nosipho was a lie. I feel like that, because how do we see you once on TV and then never see you again? How do you date somebody that you only have like one set of pictures, like the pictures where she's wearing the orange thing, that those are the only pictures we've seen her in being with Pumelelo? How is that? I feel like Pumelelo hasn't seen that girl since the last time they shot the scene. So, but yeah, I don't know. Okay. So, I feel like Utirelo couldn't hide the fact that she is so happy that Uvuyo is leaving. And it kind of feels like she is hoping that they don't make up. And the fact that Uvuyo was really walking away made her happy and she couldn't hide it. And I was like, I know that it's natural, but like it kind of made me not like Tirolo in that moment. Okay. So Tirolo's point was that, listen, you have tolerated Pumelelo for so long. The reason you are leaving is that he is not making you a number one. So if he made you number one, you would have stayed, okay? But I'm happy for you that you're leaving. This is where I was like, if I was Vuyo, if I was Vuyo, the smoke would have been coming out of my mouth, out of my eyes, out of my ears because of Tirelo, okay? Because Tirelo says, girl, like you look so happy after the breakup. You are so vocal. You've gained such self-confidence. I'm like, girl, like you are saying all the good things, but in a condescending way, like, what? You look so happy. You've broken up with my man. You look so happy. Go on. You know, with the like, I understood. Okay. She was right in saying Vuyo seemed to be more vocal, more, but I feel like it's not even that. It's not because she has broken up with Mpumelelo, it's because Vicky is around. When Vicky is around, because remember the first day, it was very hard. The first day in Sun City, it was very hard to get Uvuyo to say what was going on between her and Mpumelelo before Vuyo arrived. Snare had to poke and poke and poke before she spoke. But now that Vicky is around, she's all vocal, she's confident, she's whatever. That's why. Vuyo and Vicky, something is going on. Anyway, you guys, now when Tirelo says that, girl, you look so confident now, you're outspoken in the dinner sessions, it's like, hey, ngisho leyo. Ooh, guys. Then, oh yes, you guys, listen, before Vuyo stands up, because the gift thing happened before Vuyo stands up and leave. While Vuyo was expressing that, whatever, Mpumelelo, and the change thing, and what do I want to say? Oh, and the thing, obviously, she would have stayed had it not been for the fact that Mpumelelo doesn't want to make her number one. I now get Mpumelelo, I send a gift giving. I'm like, gift giving, yeah, and manje Tirelo. Apparently, it was Mpumelelo's birthday. I'm like, it is. Why didn't you celebrate the birthday there by your bedroom? You know, let's do what we do all the time, which is exchange gifts. When I say that if I was Vuyo, I would have had smoke come out of my ass, okay? Because of the anger that I would be feeling towards Tirelo. He okay in love. You know, let's do the gift giving, the exchange the gift. So my Vuyo, but I think when they were outside, Vicky was like, girl, like you're going to let them do you like that? Are you serious? Because now Tirelo, I was like, Tirelo, like I know you don't like Vuyo, and I know you are happy that Vuyo is leaving you with Mpumelelo. You have won the prize, honey. The thing is, we don't know the price of the prize. You understand what I'm saying? Because even 0,00 rand is still a prize. Even 1 cent is still a prize. So you have won the prize, girl, but you could have just, I think she could have just held back to the gift giving. It was just a little bit the timing of the whole thing. But I think I guess she wanted to. Now I'm the only one, I'm the only missus. I do wonder though if Tirelo is hoping for the Mamkulu position now that everybody has left because the WhatsApp group has been revamped. Everybody left the group now, it's just her and Pumelelo in the WhatsApp group. Okay. And I'm sure there's others, but the ones that are public, it's just her and Pumelelo. Okay. Now you guys, the issue now they come back and Vicky's like, guys, Vuyo was trying to express herself because Vuyo came back with Vicky to speak to Mpumelelo, while Utirelo had already left with the gift, because the exchange gift, honey, like nothing has happened, like there's no breakup that just happened here, like there's no closure for the weave that was just, you know, given here. So she leaves Utirelo, but then Uvuyo and Novuki, they come back to speak to Mpilomelelo, and then Utirelo decides to come back, because this is the thing that I'm saying. Utirelo has a worry that the two of them might actually make up, because she's happy that they've broken up. I feel like that, because why are you coming back? Are you wanting to make sure that these two are not making up? You know, guys, I don't know why they just... okay with looking like that on national TV. So she comes back again, Utirelo, and Bona Uviki, no Vuyo, they wanted to speak to Mpumelelo. Mpumelelo is not happy, because Mpumelelo is like, you know what, I don't understand why every time Vuyo wants to talk to me, she has to bring, you know, Ibuto or something. Okay, why finally have any team, meaning Uviki? Remember, even at that meeting that she wanted to ask Mpumelelo questions, she brought her mother, her aunt, and there was a whole family thing. That's what Mpumelelo is saying. Okay, now you guys, hey, because now it's a back and forth thing now between Uvuyo and Utirelo. Vuyo now all of a sudden starts talking about the fact that Mpumelelo, Mpumelelo had an infection. Not a nail infection. No, the infection that we are always talking about, the one that I always talk about, because these people are always talking about this temple, but they leave out one thing that is very, very important, which is sexual health. They don't, even there by Musa Mselegu, they don't tell us what they do it. If Mselegu has four wives and is a nginza, does he use condoms with this and how do you make sure that as a wife you use condoms now as a wife, but how did you have kids? How did you make sure that you were safe in your marriage? Nobody wants to talk about that. Yeah, it's Tembo Sihle, it's Tembo Sasemandulo. You know, our forefathers and forefathers were here, they were doing it's Tembo, but our forefathers were not dealing with HIV and AIDS. And also our forefathers, when they had infection, they went to the bush and took a leaf and ate it and the infection went away. So it's a different time. How do you deal with it? Apparently, Umelelo's pencil had some fire at some point. I'm like, good. I was like, this is an episode I need my kids to watch, okay? Because some episodes, I'm like, I know. I was like, this one I need them to watch. I just need them to know what's, yeah, that's what happens, you know, when you sleep around, okay? So Vuyo is upset. I don't even know where it comes from. I think she just wanted to expose them. I think she just wanted the public to know who the guys. While they are acting all lovey-dovey, ihithi laphayana, she says good. At some point, Mpumelelo had a, an infection, but she was never told about it. So, you know, she was acting normal. Kanti Mpumelelo had an infection, had already been diagnosed. Utirelo Lana says, it wasn't my responsibility to tell you. And then again, Uvuyo starts calling her. What, when you are a witch, you have bewitched me. I get Kwaba hitting a lap. And Utirelo starts saying, when Mpumelelo at time. Now we are getting the real, true feelings and thoughts. You got Utirelo. I was like, let me listen very carefully. Mpumelelo says, when Mpumelelo at time. You know, by the time I arrived, Mpumelelo didn't love you. You went and had a second baby with a man that did not love you. Now, there are two possibilities here. Mpumelelo discusses Vuyo a lot with Utirelo. That's one possibility, which is the reason why she would know that when she came, Mpumelelo didn't love Vuyo. Or Utirelo is saying the things that we've been saying online, because that is the thing that we have been saying online. She's just taking that and copying it and saying it to Vuyo, which is that, you know, you had a second baby with a man that didn't love you, but you also had a first baby with a man that was with many women that he didn't love or like and had an infection. What is the difference, honey? I like you, Utirelo, but what is the difference? What is the difference? Tell me. You know? Okay. So, guys, you went and had the second baby with a man that doesn't love you, and then you are a witch, you are a witch. If you think I'm a witch, then you must be witching, because how do you know about witching if you are not the one that is witching? I the witch, 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 witch. Bakom, and I guess now would do Uviku trying to stop them. Guess when Mpumelelo was? Akelanji, if you didn't watch the episode, no, he wasn't in the bathroom. No, he didn't stand up. No, he wasn't on his phone, making an important call. No, he didn't call the police. No, he didn't call the security guards. No, he did nothing. He just sat there, you know. Which is like a true reflection of how your life as a wife, Mpumelelo, is going to be while you are going in flames. Mpumelelo is just going to sit there and watch you burn. Yeah, your future is just there. I was like, Tirelo, if you don't see it, girl, like, I don't know, okay? It's right there, okay? While you are going through the flames, your man will be sitting by the sideline waiting to see if you get burnt or not, and he won't care if you do. Pumela is like, ay, vele, mabelo mina, abalwinami, so why should I? You know, abalwinami, kade babefunana, let them fight. That's what he said. Lord Jesus, if your man is not trying to get you out of going to prison, you guys, like, he's not worth it. He's not worth it at all. Because the thing about getting in a fight, the reason why people stop fights is because fights can get, you know, bad. Okay? The reason we stop people from fighting, because someone might get injured and then the police now are called, because now it's a serious thing. Somebody might end up in jail, another one might end up in the hospital. That is the reason. So when you stop somebody from fighting, you are actually preventing them from going to prison. And a lot of the time, you stop people from fighting when you care about them. But Mpumelelo was not doing it. Mpumelelo was sitting there like a 9-year-old boy wondering, ukuthi where am I? Indoda yenu, hayi Tirelo shame, hayi thatha indoda thatha indoda yakho, hayi bakhombane ke kube ke isini ke enkulu ke the production ke ended up getting ke the scene that they wanted. Now you guys, as the conclusion, Utirelo says was crying in the diary session. I'm like, girl, why are you crying? Because we know deep down you are happy that this girl is walking away from this relationship. I was trying to figure out why she was crying. Okay. Maybe in the comment section, you guys can tell me what your feelings were. Because I was feeling like, why are you crying? What is emotional? Are you sad that Vuyo has walked away? And she says that Vuyo has done horrible things to her. I wish that she could have explained it so that we know not to, okay, these are the things that you're crying about. I wasn't understanding, but she was very, very emotional in the diary session. She even says that, listen, she has decided that even though she loves Mpumelelo and Mpumelelo makes her happy, it must be very easy to make Tirelo happy, you guys. She must be very easy to make happy, because I can't imagine like Mpumelelo living the life that he lives, but he makes you happy. But obviously he makes Utirolo happy, because Utirolo is always looking very happy when she's with Mpumelelo. I don't want to lie, she does. Okay, she says that she's made a decision that even though she loves Mpumelelo and she's happy, Mpumelelo makes her happy, but if they make up. That's why I was saying earlier on that she was look when she came back to the room, it was like almost like she's like, are you coming back to make up? Because I feel like she doesn't want that. She says that if they make up with Vuyo Nompumelelo, then she's out of the relationship. So for her, she's having an issue with Vuyo, not with Nompumelelo. I guess she's okay with the behavior of Nompumelelo, but not with the behavior of Vuyo. Okay. And then Vuyo decided to drop another bomb. She's like, listen, they can go ahead and be happy with the virgin, but one thing that I can tell you is that that virgin is no longer a virgin. She said it. She said that virgin is no longer a virgin, because there is no way that Pumelelo hasn't broken that thing. So it's not a virgin, which I have been thinking. Really, I was like, so Pumelelo, the same way that he did with Unompumelelo, probably has done with Unosip. I was like, girl, thank you so much for that bomb. Now, goodbye, because it must end now. I feel like with Vuyo now, it must end. Like, we must not see Vuyo talk about Mpumelelo, must not see Vuyo fight about Mpumelelo, because she has looked stupid enough. Long enough. It's been long enough. You've looked stupid long enough, girl. I love you. Okay, move on. Move on. Take a step. And another one. And another one. The next thing you know, here is another good man coming your way. Okay, hopefully it's not Xolani Sabelo. Apparently, there is a show coming with Vuyo and Xolani Sabelo. Ngabhorekangizwa nokuzwa ukuthi leyo show iyeza. Andisebhod. Hayi ke guys, kube kanjalo ke, kube kanjalo ke. While I was lying there in the hospital, they were fighting. Anyway, you guys, tell me what you think about this in the comment section. Definitely, I don't feel like Mpumelelo is worth fighting for, especially a man that doesn't flinch, you guys, doesn't flinch. Okay, you're about to hurt somebody and you are about to be hurt, but he doesn't move. Anyway, thank you so much for watching this video. Please like it before Mpumelelo, share it with your friends, with your family, and even with strangers.